Hello and welcome to It's Only Electric and this beautiful view. I'm in Austria on a road trip to Audi's factory in Hungary, Győr. And that's a factory we're gonna visit for deep diving into Audi's premium platform electric, PPE. And we're gonna look at the assembly, the manufacturing process of the drive unit, the exact drive unit used in this car. And this is the Audi A6 Sportback Performance. It's the car we are traveling through Austria with.
It's only electric.
So now driving through Austria towards the factory in Hungary, Győr, and I'm inside the Audi A6 e-tron Sportback Performance, so it has the big battery pack. But one of the key components, the drive unit of the PPE platform, that's what we are going to look at in the factory. How it gets assembled, how they actually build and put the motor together. And it's the 270 kilowatt motor that we have at the rear here. But some brief information about the PPE platform. It stands for Premium Platform Electric. It's the Volkswagen Group's or Audi's new platform for expanding and really creating new great EVs and take market share from the other brands. It's co-developed together with Porsche. So cars using the PPE platform currently is the A6, the Q6, but also the Porsche Macan. So the PPE platform is 30% more efficient than the older one. And the motor as such is also 30% more space efficient, which means that the footprint and the installation space needed is 30% less. So it's a smaller motor, but still puts out more energy or power. And the efficiency as such is higher due to the new design and the components in the motor, of course. So it's a better overall solution. And the PPE platform also delivers the new charging technology. So instead of the old 400 volt system, it's built upon the new 800 volt system with a total charge power input, DC charging, fast charging of 270 kilowatts. That means that the big battery pack that this one has, 100 kilowatt hours, gross 95 kilowatt hours net, can charge from 10 to 80% in 21 minutes only. And that's a quick time. I have done that test several times before. The latest was with the Avant version of the A6 e-tron. And if you want to see that charge curve, I put a link up here. So please don't miss that video. Also about efficiency in general. Another important aspect of the efficiency is the thermal management of the system, the drivetrain and the battery pack. So they use a new kind of heater or heat pump, air heat pump, to regain some of the energy loss that you get when driving the car, heat. So you reuse the heat to warm up the cabin, but also to warm up the battery pack for a more efficient drive. And another very important aspect of EVs is regen. And that's also new for the PPE platform. So the regen is implemented in a different way. So instead of using the brake system, the friction brake system as a brain for the brake, you use a computer handling the regen instead. So that one handles the amount of regen you get. And at the new platform, Audi themselves states that you regen 95% of the time. So only 5% is needed for the real friction brakes. And the blend between friction and regen is handled by this computer. So it's a clever way of saving energy. So all these efficiency gains of the new PPE platform actually gives us around 40 kilometers of extra range with the same size of battery. I mean, so that's a good thing. 40 kilometers is very important gain in range compared to the older platforms. And I mean, that's what we're looking for. We can't only work with like pumping up the battery size, adding kilowatt hours to the battery, adding capacity, because that's expensive, but it also is environmentally bad. We need to use the energy we have in a as good way as possible. And that's why efficiency is so important on EVs compared to combustion engines. Because when you drive a combustion engine, you will still waste 60 to 70% in hot air. I mean, all those explosions will end up in like a efficiency usage of like 20, 30%. All the rest is heat. And that's the opposite way around when it comes to EVs. I mean, there is motors using like 95% of the energy to output power. So you only lose 5% in heat and friction. That's a very big difference. And that's why it's so important that you have heat pumps, you have good bearings, you have a efficient aerodynamically car like this one is. It has 0.21 as a CV value. That's good. It's less than the Avant version. And that's also why this one has the longest range among the pack, so over 700 kilometers of range, close to 800. And some facts about the car I'm driving now. I mean, as I said, I have tested the Avant version, so I really wanted to test, and I specifically asked Audi for a Sportback. And I wanted to have more of a basic Sportback. So this is this performance version, which means that it has the big battery pack of 100 kilowatt hours gross and 95 net. Gives us a range of 756 kilometers. That's really good. So it's the rear wheel drive setup with a 270 kilowatt hours power output at the rear only. And the thumb thing is that the exact motor or drive unit I'm gonna assemble on the factory. And I'm also gonna show you the assembly line of the motors. So that's interesting. I'm driving that exact motor now. So stay tuned for the factory visit. We are on the way. 0 to 100 in 5.4 seconds. That's also a good number for such a big car and only rear wheel drive. But it's a nice car to drive. And what I like is that I got a version with regular mirrors, because to be honest, I know that the digital mirrors lowers the drag coefficient, the air resistance, but I still prefer to have the regular mirrors because I think they present a better view for you as a driver. I'm in Hungary, Győr, at Audi's factory. So here is where Audi actually produces the drive units for the new PPE platform. And the factory itself is carbon neutral with Europe's biggest solar panel roof, and they also do things like biodiversity, they have beehives, etc., to be as environmental friendly as possible. And it's very windy, so we're gonna go into the factory. I'm gonna show you how to assemble the drive unit, but also gonna show you the robotics and the assembly itself, the automations, etc. So this is an exciting moment for me. I have been waiting to do this for a while now. So we're gonna have a look at how the assembly works. For this is a permanent magnet PPE motor from Audi, producing up to 270 kilowatts. This is the stator. We have the rotor and transmission and the power electronics, so the inverter. So this is more or less how it looks, and we're gonna check out the factory. So here behind me, we have the production site or the robots for the PPE motor. So it's actually put together here, and it's a big magnetic field, of course, so it's protected. And as you see, the robots are coordinated and working all together to output as many motors as possible. And as you see there, now it pushes down the rotor into the capsule or the actual drive unit itself. To the left of me, we have the final high voltage check,
and the motor unit or drive unit continues on the band, and these robots actually print the serial number of the drive unit, the final drive unit. So this is where the drive unit actually gets registered. Now we have a robot coming over there, so I need to move over because it's highly automated, of course. And after getting the actual serial number printed on the aluminium housing, it actually double checks on the camera here that the serial number is readable and okay. A drive unit is not a full drive unit if you don't have the drive shaft attached to it. And this is kind of the lid on top of the drive unit where you have the drive shaft connector and the differential connector. And this one is actually assembled automatically on the way, and some of the bolts are installed just to get it aligned, and the final bolts are actually bolted in by this guy behind me. So there's some small amount of manual work going on here, but I mean, that's to optimize the total production and throughput time of each drive unit. And each drive unit takes around 25 to 30 minutes to complete in this gear factory. And the total daily output is around 2,000 drive units. And that's impressive. And by the way, I didn't say that, but I think it goes without saying by explaining and showing you the robots and the assembly. This is the permanent magnet motors that Audi on the PPE platform uses at the rear drive axle. So permanent magnet motors, this is not the induction motors we see here. This big assembly step is one of the last ones, and it's the silent blockers. So we install this kind of bushings, or silent blockers as they call it, to the motor, the drive unit, and this is for the attachment of the actual drive unit to the chassis of the car and to pick up and destroy the vibrations. So this will give you a very vibration-free and smooth ride, because I mean, it's powerful motors and this is really needed. So before the motor is shipped and usable, it goes through severe quality checks. And as you see here, this is a fully assembled motor or drive unit coming in, and these rooms here with robots is actually the full self-test of the drive unit. You test the torque, the power of the motor, the output, the vibrations. Everything is tested, so they make sure to deliver fully functional motors before it leaves the factory. This is how the final drive units look like, and this is the PPE platform units for Audi. So that means that the rear motor is the permanent magnet motor we're looking at now, together with all the electronics on top. Here on my right side we have the induction motor on the front axle. At the same time, we actually also have Porsche Macans set up here. And what's the difference, you will ask me? And the difference is that one of these are, or both, are actually permanent magnet motors. So Macan does have dual permanent magnet motors instead of a induction motor at the front.
Okay. It's a bit powerful.
Nope, you should turn it towards you.
That way?
And hold it pretty strong together. Okay. Nice.
Almost.
In the rotor, that there.
Yeah.
Oh, super. Perfect.
Perfect. Oh, I got a machine. So after a long drive to the factory in gear, I'm on my way back, traveling through Austria again, back all the way to Munich airport, flying home. It has been a great experience. Really appreciated the visit to the factory. So thank you, Audi. And also thank you for showing me, letting me see this beautiful environment. And whilst talking about the environment, I can really recommend you guys, if you haven't been to Austria, take your EV and do a road trip through Austria. It's amazing. And you don't need to worry that much about chargers, because there is fast chargers, very widely spread and conveniently placed. So very easy to do road trips in Austria with a EV. So a warm recommendation from me. About the car, I have been enjoying the drive of the Sportback, and I know that in Sweden Avants are really the thing, and that's because of the practical aspects, and some may think that the Avant looks better, but the Sportback doesn't come with any downsides. I mean, it has a slightly smaller boot, but it's still a hatchback or a combi coupe, which means that you open the boot widely and you get, it's practical, let me say it that way. I think it's better looking and it's more efficient, so you have more range. It's more slippery, so less wind resistant, so lower drag coefficient, 0.21 instead of 0.25. That's actually a big difference. And that's also why this is the range topping version. It's a bit cheaper, so it comes with a lot of gains. And I think it looks a bit cooler, actually. Yeah, and they are not that common in Scandinavia or in Sweden, so why not go for the Sportback? This will be perfectly fine for a family. It's a big car, but it's really smooth, especially with the air suspension. Love the air suspension. It's really two-faced in a good way, as it should be. I mean, if you drive it in sport, you really stiffens up, supports your driving more dynamically, and if you want to do a more comfortable ride and drive through landscapes on highways, then you can do that in comfort mode without any downsides. It's really smooth and it's silent. It's a perfect highway car. But at the same time, you can really like press it a bit, drive it a bit more dynamic. And the rear-wheel drive motor is fully perfect for that. It's more than enough powerful. I mean, you don't need more power. You have enough of acceleration. It's a good choice. I think that's all for today. I've been talking a lot, so I think it's time to wrap up. So as I always say, please share your thoughts, write comments about the car, ask me questions about the factory, the PPE platform. Let us have a discussion. And also let me know if you like this kind of videos, because I mean, it is not a regular review. It's a more detailed video about something more specific. I like to do such things, and I hope you enjoy that. But share your thoughts. And as usual, stay electric. Thank you for watching. Speak to you soon.